Hi, we're here at Hannover Messe and we're at the HPE booth, and I'm here with Andy Longworth. You're the solution architect for data analytics. If we talk about manufacturing and AI, we always think immediately of video analytics because this is one of the first practices that the company started with. So what are the main challenges with this?
So one of the main challenges is getting access to that data. The video analytics takes a lot of bandwidth, so making sure that you can feed the data into the platforms that you have, collecting the data at the right point, and being able to process it to the point where you say, okay, now I can start to push that through my models. Then when you've pushed it through the models, you have to kind of close the loop and decide what you're going to do with the action out of it. So, you know, if you make a prediction, you've got to do something with that prediction to make use of it. Otherwise, you might well have never made that prediction in the first place.
And what are the main use cases that you see in the market?
So we're seeing a lot of traction around quality control or quality assurance, using video analytics, so on the production line without having to stop things. But we also see use cases outside of the factory with autonomous driving being a huge thing at the moment, and building those models to support them and processing that data at the right place.
And about processing, how can you manage your pipelines best?
So first you need to decide where do I need to process that data. So if you look at the autonomous drive example, a car needs to be able to make a decision in a split second about whether it needs to brake or swerve based on something that's in front of it. So you need to process that in the car right there and there. But then if you have things like monitoring the brake pads, do I need to change those? That's less critical, so that you can process that after the fact, maybe send something back to the data center and make a recommendation to the customer about having the car serviced after the fact.
And one of the main parts is the models, the algorithms. So what kind of options do companies have if they start building models?
Oh, they have a huge amount of options. And I think for some people, there's almost too many options out there. You have commercial off-the-shelf products that you can build or buy for particular use cases. So if you look at the video analytics for security, there are point solutions out there for that. But if customers want to start building things themselves, there's a plethora of open source tools and frameworks. If we think about TensorFlow, Keras, YOLO, there's loads of different models out there and different frameworks that they can leverage. I think what they first need to do is understand what's the use case and what do I need to do with that video stream or that picture's data that I have, and then pick the model that best fits their needs.
And one of the best use cases is to start with video analytics. Andy, thanks a lot for your insights. Thank you for watching here from the HPE booth at Hannover Messe. Enjoy this video? Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and get notifications of my new video.